way ahead of the curve here. What we've done is disqualified planet Earth for 8,500 years. So we became the Pandoras by opening the box up, and the box was mathematics.
Let freedom ring!
No one ever went to war over a math problem in the history of mankind. Now taking and having the knowledge to specifically target mathematics and move it into any language, you can rewrite any language in the quantums. And that means that's a rewrite of every constitution, every trade agreement, every corporation contract worldwide. You know, a contract writing pays about $1,000 an hour, just below brain surgery. So when you learn this and you become proficient at it, you can make a wonderful living at it. Walking into the companies and saying, you know what, this is how much fraud you got. Now, July 2nd, last year, I had a car accident. And in the car accident, I broke my back. I had 3 vertebrae that my 3, 4, and 5 were separated, which hit my sciatic nerve. My right leg was paralyzed. And I thought, well, you know, this is really bad news. So I put on a body brace and took some hydrocodone for the pain. Got myself adjusted with a chiropractor and laid down for 3 days until things got to healing. Now, one of the things about healing a person is, some of you have heard me talk about the word Zapper, Z-A-P-P-E-R. It's a Holda Clark program. Well, 30 kilohertz frequency for a Zapper amplifies your reproductive healing on something that's broken, like cartilage, 4 times faster than normal. So with a body brace on and the frequency running through the cartilage, I was able to repair it in 72 hours. So I could take the brace off and I was back to normal with no pain, which was something that normally you'd take 3 or 4 months to get yourself put back together. And I did it in 3 days. So it's, we'll get into that more of that later in that. But the people, when I said, you know, I got a broken back, what's the insurance going to pay? He says, well, I'll give you $500. Excuse me? 70 days of pain and $500? I don't think so. And my friend who got hurt too with a brain concussion, she's still suffering 9 months later, and they offered her $500. I'm going like, I don't think so. This is a permanent disability now. And so I went ahead and I pulled the insurance policies on Geico, State Farm, Farmers, Allstate, Prudential. I've been going through all the insurance companies. Now, just like I did with the mortgages that you're all familiar with, when I syntaxed that with Washington Mutual on January 6, 2008, that's cost the United States government $40 trillion, that one lawsuit. Just because somebody goes, ah, this is not, don't mean anything. Yeah, well, $40 trillion hit is pretty big on the economy, you know? Right now, there's 30 million people in foreclosure. That's 40% of the United States population. 22% unemployment in the United States, and it's going to accelerate. Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac are filing bankruptcy for $40 trillion because of that lawsuit in 2008. When people laugh and say, this doesn't mean anything, who's going to write a check for that? And then now I got the insurance company laughing at it. I'm going like, you know what I did with insurance? I mean, what I did with mortgages? All the insurance companies are in the same boat. I tried to buy stock in the stock market the other day. You know what the stock market told me? You're not allowed to buy stock. You're not allowed to trade. You're not allowed to have a security. I'm like, why? Because you disqualified all the securities of all the stock markets in the world. Because all securities are in a box written in italics, double-spaced, and an adverb verb. I mean, how much of a perfect zero can you create? Now, if we allow you to come into our stock markets, you would disqualify all the stock markets in the world. If we allow you to come into our schools, you'd disqualify all of our universities, colleges, and high schools. But when I got done with the Chinese government writing a $20 trillion trade agreement, all colleges, universities, and high schools in China are now teaching my program. South Korea's been doing it for 8 years. So this technology is expanding. I think I have 1.4 billion people over in China. And they're all studying to English because they have 10,000 letters in their alphabet, but only 26 in English. So being able to do that's a very simple thing to learn, especially with mathematics. 26 is a lot easier than 10,000. And now that it's mathematically certified, frontwards and backwards, you can't cheat them. So that puts us in a very, very powerful position as a director planet-wide. And now that I've seen the other languages that I'm going after, with both the insurance and the mortgages, you know, my mortgage issues are affecting Europe, all over Europe, and Russia, and China, because of the old adverb-verbs grammar. And even though these are some of the communist countries, they still have to deal with, you can't say 3 + 3 = 7. Nobody's going to follow that. They're going to go ahead and they're going to really come after you for that grammar fraud. So the technology that we were getting, now we're expanding into the insurance field. No car insurance, no life insurance, no medical insurance, no product liability insurance. What happens if we lose the insurance industry? Well, I went to State of Wisconsin Department of Insurance, and I brought in the three directors of Wisconsin's insurance directors. And I walked in and I said, I want to talk to you guys. And he says, you have an appointment. I says, I'm a federal judge. I don't make appointments. You guys in a room right now, quiet. And after I went on a 45-minute presentation, they were all sitting there crying. They all thought they were going to prison. And he realized that I just had collapsed the entire industry of insurance. Now, 3 + 3 = 6, that's correct, right?
Yes.
And if I put IN in front of the word correct, it means not correct, right? So if I have a surety, which I bought on the stock market,
insurance means
surety, and IN assurance, ANCE means contract. ENT is contract, ION is contract. All these words that end in words, these are called contract words. You'll learn this when you study parsec grammar. So I said to him, I broke it down. There's three syllables, insurance. And I says, sure means to have a security, right? And she goes, yeah, all three agree with me. I says, and ANC is a contract. And I said, yeah, we understand syntax. And if I put IN in front of that, then I have no such a security contract, right? They're going like, oh my God, it's with the Department of No Security Contract. And right then and there, they had a revolution about what parse was, of what insurance meant. Then I pulled out the Farmers and State Farm insurance policies, which I had syntax 60 pages of, and I laid them out on the table, and I said, and these people don't want to pay. Well, they did a little investigation. They pay on 9%. That's it. They pay 9% of the claims, and they harvest 91% of the claims. And those that they only pay 10 cents on a dollar, so they're only paying 1% out of the 99% premiums they harvest. That's why they're putting up these 50-story apartment buildings. Or, you know, office buildings for the insurance company. So when they're looking at the numbers, I'm going, when I talk to an adjuster now, I don't listen to what that adjuster says. I go right to the CEO and I says, you want to take care of the medical expenses or do you want me to close your company? The fine under Title 15, Section 1692E, is false and misleading statements. Bernie Madoff, $69 billion off of Wall Street. Everybody knows the story. Under Title 15, Section 78FF, it's a $25 million fine for false and misleading statements. Once the document is syntax and proved that it's an engineering nightmare. And it is. So how many clients does Farmers have, or State Farm, or Prudential, or Geico? 5-10 million customers. Every one of them is a $25 million fine against the insurance company. Now, if the United States government wants to go ahead and they want to pay off the debt, they can walk into the bank, which has a number 26 and 213 zeros after it. That was 2 years ago. Now it's probably 215 or 16 zeros after it with compounded interest. And say to the International Monetary Fund, we're going to zero out this debt because I've got a $25 million charge against 67 million mortgages and about as many, and how many cars are insured in the United States? 400 million people. So we've probably got upwards around 200 million automobiles or trucks and cars, and it's all fraud. So each one of them carries a $25 million fine. So the insurance company's got to cough up enough money to pay off the national debt. Out of all this money they got in their hopper, along with the banks. And because, you know, what would that be? One less zero than 213 would be 212 zeros? Like, how much is enough?
Let freedom ring. About your age.